Hello everyone, so today we're gonna make some little truffles. Those ones are flavored with Cointreau. You can flavor them with anything you like, dark rum, brandy, any kind of alcohol, whiskey, any kind of alcohol you fancy. You can replace the same amount for this one, and they are really good. Should we try one? John? He likes alcohol, so I'm sure he's gonna like it. Nice?
Beautiful.
So you see, it has a very thin coating of chocolate, and the ganache inside is so creamy. It's amazing. So let's make it. So we're gonna start with the cream. So we need 240 gram whipping cream. There. And 140 gram of Cointreau. Into your cream. Wow, exactly. I can't believe that. I finished the bottle. 140 grams. Okay, that's gonna go on the stove. And we're gonna use Calbo chocolate pistols. 54% cocoa. It's a quite nice chocolate. Usually I'm using Varona or Calbo. Sometimes it change. So here we need 500 grams. It would have been too beautiful. It's missing 26 grams. Okay, it's okay. Let's get another one. Yep. Okay, they're very nice. Very cool. Okay, so we are waiting for our cream and Cointreau to boil, and we're gonna pour it onto our chocolate. It is boiling, so we're gonna pour it onto our 500 gram. Smell amazing, the Cointreau. Very boozy. I gently whisk. Nearly there. Okay, cool. And I think that's it. All nice and melted. Let's scrape the sides. Tasty, tasty. Delicious. That can be reserved into a fridge. Or leave it outside for it to set on its own. Cling film against it, so it doesn't go crusty. And I got one ready. So this one, I made it earlier. So it has really set, okay. Maybe a bit too much because I put it in the fridge. And it's so delicious. It's melting, it's really good. And you have really the intense flavor of the Cointreau. And it's not too much alcohol flavor. You really have the taste of the orange. So this one we're gonna pipe it as well in the freezer and dip into the chocolate. Okay. is a little bit hard. I should have leave it a little bit longer to come back to the room temperature. I'm gonna warming it up like that. Yeah. Okay. So little bubbles again. Oops, this one does. This one was not working. Okay, so all piped now is going to the freezer. My God! He doesn't want to go in! There we go. So we're gonna wait. Okay, so they're frozen now. I got some melted dark chocolate, 45 degrees. And we're gonna do a mix with icing sugar and corn flour to finish them. So we're gonna need, not sure how much yet we're gonna do. If we do, if you base yourself on 300 grams of icing sugar and 150 of corn flour, so that will help the icing sugar not to melt at all, you know. It will remain white even with humidity. Mix it through together. Okay, so now it's time to dip our chocolate truffle. We're just gonna take few to start with. So they're frozen. Okay, so same technique as the previous chocolate truffle we made. Let's start with three. Squeeze the excess of chocolate into the icing sugar. Another three. Oops. Always make sure you shake it well, because otherwise it's gonna set. See, it's setting very quickly, but you really want to roll it in the icing sugar before it sets. And do only two, three or four at a time, because if they last too long into this chocolate here, the shell will be too thick, you know? The chocolate is gonna set, and build up, and it's gonna be too thick. You want a very thin coat. So that's why you squeeze it between your finger, yeah? Squeeze. Okay, so now I'm gonna take them out, shake them, the excess of icing sugar. And the chocolate is already set. It's brilliant. So perfect timing for Christmas to do those and to enjoy them with your family. Okay, so that's it, guys. Little Cointreau truffle. I think it's defrost now. So you have this thin shell again, and this ganache with the Cointreau. And it's so tender. It's really a good one. So, that's all. Please, if you like our video, if you want to know what's coming next, subscribe, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.